could have been so good, this internet of ours. And that's what it is, ours. Or is it? Whose is it? Who owns what's on it? When it first started, or perhaps more appropriately stated, when we all started getting interested in it and seeing its potential, you knew that any work of yours that you put on there, whatever was said, was actually you giving it to the world, or whoever happened to come across it, that was. So, if you put any of your art, or your poetry, or your writings, or your thoughts, or your music, anything, online, it became a part of the public domain. It became the property of all. And that's kind of utopian in a way. I mean, I know that we all have to pay what is effectively, that might feel quite expensive, a nominal fee to have access to the internet. Once we're there, it's all fair game, because along with that was written in the ability to help oneself. The technicians made that happen. And that was quite extraordinary, something which did not exist in the physical world, had not existed in the physical world, either in living memory or in written memory. A genuine sharing, a giving of what you had to offer was there. It was unregulated, wild, random. And I mean, for that reason, in some respects, quite dangerous. And of course, the danger itself has not gone. But I don't think that the danger is mostly difficult people. It seems to me that what is stealing this freedom, this utopia from us, is big business. Saying, hang on, there's an opportunity here for us to make money. We can steal things, claim that they're ours, and make you pay. We can take you to court. We can stop you from doing what you want to do. We can curtail your freedom because we're big and you are small. What's inspired me to make this video is the recent thing at YouTube of muting quite a lot of videos, removing videos, a so-called copyright infringement. And I think there's a tendency and a temptation to blame the musicians for that, but actually I suspect that the musicians have remarkably little, if anything, to do with it. I don't know if any of you have noticed, I'm sure many of you have, that if you go onto some videos now with music, it offers you the opportunity to download it through iTunes. You think that's free? Well, we all know it's not. They are saying this is ours and we want to make money from it. To hell with your creative efforts. To hell with the fact that you're actually doing no more than sharing what you might in your own living room. We want money. Big business is slowly but surely taking over this huge, chaotic, free place. And yet that was the gift of it, that was the pleasure and the joy of it. That we could all kind of become mixers of others' creativity, sharers, communicate with one another relatively freely and without censorship. And that is slowly being eaten away by big business. Just as it is in the world. And I don't know how or if this can be prevented in any way, stopped. But I would certainly like to make note that I very much appreciated those few years when we could actually live what I would see as more of our true nature than we might imagine, just to share amongst ourselves and to communicate and to enjoy that freedom. Let's not get too caught up in the notion that humanity is only like these greedy businesses that want to take that from us, or who want to control people. It's a little more complex than that. And when it comes to the point where I have no freedom left on here, I will walk away, having gained a great deal. But I will not be bound or limited by them.